गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट क्लास वी स्टार्टेड ए न्यू चैप्टर कॉल्ड टेंस, न्यू पोर्शन, एंड इन दैट आई गिव यू द इंट्रोडक्शन व्हाट इज टेंस, व्हाट आर इट्स डिफरेंट डिविजन्स और सेक्शंस एंड ऑल दैट वी सॉ इन द लास्ट क्लास. Today we are going to see out of those top tenses that we studied, the first one, simple present tense. Simple present tense. Simple present tense is used to speak about an action that takes place at the present moment. Things that take place at the present moment in general. Okay. For example, I teach you English language. I teach you English language. Okay, the COVID-19 pandemic spreads. Like that, things in general, what's happening now, to talk about that, we use simple present tense. And the structure of the sentence is subject plus V1 or V5 form of the verb plus object. This is the simple structure of a sentence in simple present tense. Okay, subject V1 or V5. I told you I teach English language. I teach English language. Fine. So I is the subject, teach is the verb, English language is the object. Now here I wrote V1 or V5. Subject is first person singular. We use V1 verb. Subject is first person plural. We use V1 verb. Subject is second person both singular and plural. We use V1 verb. Subject is third person plural. We use V1 verb. But when the subject is third person singular, the verb will be V5 form. When I told you about the conjugation, the five forms of the verb, I have told you this. Teaches English language. Okay. So that's where we use V5 form. If the subject of your sentence is third person singular, he, she, it, or one name, then your verb is in V5 form. So this is the structure of the sentence. Okay? And while making a sentence in simple present tense into question,
I should not have wrapped that.
I teach English. Language. Now, if you are making question, do I teach English language or what do I teach? These way questions can be formed. Now, whatever is the case, when you have do in your this one, you have the verb is in V1 form. And this is how we have to do it. Now, how do we get this? That also I have told you earlier. We studied that conjugation of forms of verbs for did, done, doing, does. At that time I told you these are the basic five forms of the action verb. So this verb teach actually comes do plus teach is equal to teach. Now does plus teach is equal to teaches. Fine?
Understood. Did plus teach is taught. Doing plus teach is teaching. Done plus teach is taught again with reform.
So you have to, when you have to make a question, you have to split this verb teach into this do plus teach and put the do before the subject. Fine. Subject and the remaining verb that is teach English. If you use question word what also it comes what do I teach. The same format that is here.
This is how a question is to be formed in a simple present tense.
Now let's look at the negative formation. How to form negative? That is, I do not teach English language. Here also same thing. You split this word. When you split, you will get this. Do plus teach. So I do and not. Between this do and be one form of the verb, and not is added.
I not teach English. This is a wrong usage. Many people use that. I not teach English. I not teach English. It is not correct.
It will be I do not teach English. How do we get it? This teach that is there in the positive form or the affirmative form, we split into two. You get do and teach, and add or insert a not between this do and teach.
Okay, so that's how the negative is formed. Did you get that? That's how the negative is formed in simple present tense. So sentence structure, subject plus V1 or V5 form of the verb plus object. Question form, you have to have do or does before the subject. Okay? And negative form, you add a not after do or does not. Does. Is that clear? And how do you get that? I told you, you have to split the action word, and it can be split into do plus the action word and does plus the action word, V1 form of the verb, and you get it. Is that clear? Now we go into
the quickly usages, one I already told you.
Next, we use simple present tense in speaking about scientific facts. Scientific facts, okay?
The sun rises in the evening, in the morning.
The sun rises in the morning, or sun sets in the evening, or something that is thrown up falls down. It does not go up. Okay? Or rain comes down. Natural truths. Proverbs. All that glitters is not gold. Make hay while the sun shines.
So whenever you have to do all this or make sentences for these purposes, you have to make then talking about natural truths.
The rain comes down, I told you. Or honey is sweet. We have not heard of a bitter honey, isn't it? Okay? It's a reality. It's a natural truth. Okay? Or 2 plus 2 is a 4. Then talking about a planned future event. For a planned future event, which is already fixed. For example, let's say my father is arriving tomorrow. He wanted to visit this place. He wants to see this place. So maybe 2-3 months in advance he planned, he has booked his ticket and all, and tomorrow is the date there. So it is going to happen tomorrow, but still I can tell you, my father comes tomorrow for a planned future action. Or Saturday I celebrate my birthday. It's not true, I'm just telling you as an example, don't take it seriously. So I already planned, I invited my friends, I have planned what is to be done on that day, okay, where it will be done, everything is planned and fixed. So that is what is. Then in running commentaries, you hear a lot, cricket commentaries. I'm sure youngsters and children like you are very much interested. okay, and in the what you call some names of the players, okay, comes forward, kicks the ball, and it makes a goal. So like that, talking about running commentaries, we use simple present tense. Okay, sometimes in a in if clauses, if you study well, you will pass in the examination. If you study well, you will pass in the examination. Is that clear? So these are the some of the uses. Now I'll be sending your study materials. Go through that, and also please do the exercises that is given there. Is that clear? Thank you.